may problema siya. And I do not to, want to add to the to her woes of the day. May maisip pa siya na ano ilang nago. Basta sa kami, tabi ko noon, na may malaking problema. Eh, yun lang. Kasi pareho kami prosecutor. Eh, ako talaga, pisa ako doon sa baba, may trial prosecutor for 10 years. Alam ko ang laro, pati yung lumalaban, pag hinuli mo kasi ang governor mayor noon, lalaban yan, magkagera kayo. Ang pulis takot. Dito sa akin, walang politiko magsabi sa akin dito na bubulsitin kita. Governor ka, magsabi ka sa akin, mayor, itong bata ko, no? Gusto mo sipain kita niya, puntahan kita. Kaya it was, maybe I said, God's way of doing it. Wala akong nakuha, wala nga akong barangay captain isa dito sa Manila. Ubus kisa sa yung kapitbahay mo. Yung neighborhood, ha? Totoo.
Yes, I know, sir. You were saying that no one really supported
so wala you during akong, walang governor o military could have the goal to save you. Sabihin ko sa kanan, ina mo, wala akong utang na loob sa'yo at wag mo, hindi ako ganun.
So, sir, what, yung sagot niyo po dun kay Senator Lyla de Lima, would you care to answer that? Ano ho yung end goal? San ho kaya ito pupunta? And is do you want to see her behind bars?
You know, she has denial. It leaves a bad taste in the mouth to be uttering on it. Ito yan siya. Ilang testigo siya, not even one, nagsabi na hindi totoo yan. It started, nagkalat na. So, tapos nangyari, saan ka makakita ng munting lupa na parang, hindi na ano, matakot makulong yan. May nightclub, may babae, may inom, mahilig rin ako magtikangkang ng mga baril-baril dyan. O di happy na ako, ano, pwede ka magbili ng mga libro. I only need a lampshade and a book and I'm through for the night. Daytime, I sleep. So, walang problema. Kung ganun lang naman ang presuhan, so, what gives? So, siya ngayon, ang sabi ko, kung ganun ang nangyari, sa noon pa, and I had an occasion to, sabi ko, Senator, may problema kayo, better. And that was about 8 months when I testified, no, 8 months after, when I testified in the Senate, remember, about the rice smuggling, it, I was pictured to be a ruffian because of my mouth. Ganon talaga ako. So take it or leave it ako dyan. Kasi sa kampanya, talagang halos isang katirbang mura, ang, lalo na kung if you are in a impassioned speech. Pero at least ginawa ko.
Okay.
Walang corruption. Corruption, upakan talaga kita. And even my two fraternity brothers in Upaka.
Yes, always said
no,
that at
but,
any time.
Yung sabihin me to oust. Well, probably I'll give you a good fight.
You know,
you'll get the bloody nose. Sigurado yan.
You know, I wanted to, that was obviously part of my questions a little later on, but since you brought it up, sir, these allegations supposed to be of ousting the president, how seriously do you take them? Very recently, meron supposed to be, Mr. President, this blueprint from the former ambassador. Are these something, number one, you believe
well,
in? How seriously do you take them?
In the matter of the credible news, kind of, maybe you may have some, an inkling of how this guy operates. Because most of the ambassadors of the United States, but not all, are not really professional ambassadors. Yung mga career, at the same time, they do spying. They are really connected with the CIA. Ganun yan eh. The ambassador of a country is the number one spy. But there are ambassadors of the United States, yung forte nila is really to undermine governance. And that's what happened with Bolgerang, Bolivia.
Oh, yeah.
He was expelled because he was undermining the native president there. And they say that there's a good article, Time magazine, I think, and it has a good analysis of how the elite of that country hates that native president. And Goldberg started to dig under, to erode the foundation of the presidency, and he was expelled a persona non grata. Ako naman, this is my message to the United States and to everybody, to those out there on the streets and for those who are demanding my resignation. You know, I feel that I have to honor the contract with the people. Pero kung sabihin mo na tatakutin mo ako or that you'd be happy to see me out, I view life as a matter of destiny, all of what happens here in this universe. So, with little money and no machinery at all, I won the presidency. So to me, it's there has to be something in there. So when I asked somebody, he said, maybe there's a message from you, from God, or from you to whatever gusto mong i-communicate. From you to whom? Sabi ko, well, sabi ko, kasi siguro talaga ng Diyos na ilagay ako dito. So it's destiny. So if I get to survive 6 months and one day, that's part of my destiny. That is your presidency in this planet. If I am still around next year to host the ASEAN, that's my destiny. So sabi ko, okay, kung anong ibigay ng Panginoong Diyos sa akin, natanggapin ko yan. Pero kung sabihin mo ako, you mess up with me. Wala naman ako sabi, but I could give you a bloody nose, really. It was the message that I was hearing. And it was corruption in government, drugs, which is really a virulent thing now. And it's just too bad that I cannot show to the people and all of you the chart of how things are going. But most of the big time are really still very big, and always maybe undermining also government. O talagang we have not shown enough to them. Pero nakita mo naman sa San Juan, isang tunelada, and that would give you an idea the activity of the drug system in this country.
Well, that is your campaign promise, Mr. President.
Yes.
Sabi niyo po, nung kampanya, 3 to 6 months. In September, 3 months after you assumed the post, sabi mo, I need a little extension because you didn't know how grave the problem was.
I was just mayor dealing with a problem of a small town city. In my town, in my city, wala masyadong drugs. I mean, Davao is comfortable where it is now. Nakakalakad yung mga tao na gusto nila. At wala masyadong krimen kasi walang mga tao na nasa droga. So it's a bit peaceful. But when I said, how naive of me rather. Kasi yung sinasabi ko, I'll finish it in 6 months. I was looking at the Philippines. Ang akala ko ganun lang.
Davao.
Shabu dito, shabu doon kunti. Mm-hmm. But I didn't know that when I became the president, I started to squeeze everybody. So you saw the hundreds of thousands of Filipinos. Not counting the original figure given by General Santiago Padilla before, pegging it at 3 million. Itong akin, I have it. As I have said, by the end of the year, I would have hit 1 million. So you add another to Santiago's original number. You add mine, which is about 1 million. So there are 4 million. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It is no joke. It is not just a problem which you can ignore or give just about 5-10 minutes attention every day.
Yeah.
You have to worry about the repercussions. Drugs, you know, that's why I kill you. Why? Let me put it this way. If you're asking me if I am happy with the presidency, I'll give you this answer. I don't need it at this time of my life. I'm sorry to say it, but I will work and work and work. But kung ano, maybe it's because of age or the grueling trips that you have to make day to day. It would depend on what develops or what evolves around the country. And so I get to travel a lot. And about the only time, and the purpose of going around ASEAN countries is because we're hosting the summit next year. And you have to get the feel of what you'd like to present to the ASEAN. So you have to get into the yung dibdib ng tao. So what do you want us to present or make a representation of what particular matter that are subject closest to your heart? And I had that's why I had to travel, but I hate traveling. You might as well know that I hate to travel, but I had to go there because it's my duty, being the host country probably around towards the end of November next year, God willing, hopefully.